All right, Scott, 2 weeks ago at the EWO, if I would have told you that you guys would come here, punch a guy into the finals at a 15 seed, would you have called me a liar, or would you just call, are you just a believer you could do it?
I mean, I think, you know, with the sports and athletics, and when you're the underdog, you got to believe. And, you know, Ronnie Perry came to wrestle. I mean, how about it? Coming in just right away with a major decision, running through the brackets, Sorensen, Surtsis, Kolodzic. I think when you show up and you have a good weekend, anything can happen. And we've seen that before at the national tournament. Ronnie Perry came to wrestle. You know, he was poised. He was confident. It's really a dream came true. I mean, for him, for the program, you know, tremendous effort. I think he's on fire right now. It's the best I've ever seen him wrestle. And as someone who's deserving of this opportunity to be on the big stage at the NCAA Championships, representing Lock Haven, I think it's big for the program. That's the biggest thing for me, is continue to move the program forward, continue to develop young athletes like Ronnie Perry, 7th in the state, national finalist. Hopefully that'll speak volumes, you know, as continue to build our program and make our presence known on the national scene.
Talking to Dave Boyard, they had their first, you know, All-American since 1999. It's a great weekend of first. You know, you haven't had an NCAA finalist since Kerry Collat. How crazy is that to think it's been 20-plus years since you guys have had EW All titles, NCAA finalists, and the success has come back to you? Eastern Michigan, now that's, you know, you guys are pretty similar, mid-major, right?
Right.
On the rise. Well, you guys are a PSAC school, actually.
Yeah.
So you look at that, what's that do for recruiting? Does it show people they can win there?
I mean, we've been preaching for a while and, you know, been putting the work in. You know, you follow the program, you know what kind of work we've been putting in. We've been hustling. Bottom line, man, we've been getting out there, hustling, recruiting, training, fundraising, what we do for our program. We fundraise every single dollar that we get for scholarship. Okay, so we push the pace, we think outside the box, we have a business mindset, and our guys buy in, they believe it, they see what it takes to be successful, and it just takes time. You know, sometimes you just gotta get the guys believing and developing, and you get the guys in a room. Guys like Chance Marsteller came in a room this year, leading by example, workout partners with Ronnie Perry, both All-American, both won within 30 seconds each other tonight. These guys are amazing, man. I'll tell you what, I'm having an experience of a lifetime this weekend. I'm overjoyed, really speechless, but not. I'm just calm. Awesome. Finalists, Ronnie Perry, All-American, Chance Marsteller, two All-Americans, Lock Haven University. I think the rise is pretty real right now, but we'll have to see what everybody says after this.
You've changed Chance's life. This is such a positive change for him in his life. You might have saved his life. Do you look at it like that? I mean, you've changed his life, man. You gave him a second opportunity where a lot of these guys, great guys, high school wrestlers, you know, they go and they fade off into obscurity. This guy's an All-American for you.
Yep.
You know, he's probably going to be representing the United States in a World Cup or something someday. He's pretty good. What's it mean to know that you probably saved this guy in his path in life?
It means everything. I mean, Chance is a great kid. He had some tough times, but he's a great kid. He deserves every second of this being an All-American. He's been through a lot. He's the toughest dude I know. I mean, there's not many kids that can go through what he's been through and even get close to where he's at right now. I'm proud of him. I know his emotions probably aren't there right now. He's looking to win some more matches. That's a kid who's been through more than anybody that I've ever known. And to say that he came through, battled adversity, didn't start the tournament off great, but finishing on a high note, beating Richie Lewis. This dude's a machine. I mean, these guys are believing, they're buying in, they're training. They're fighting adversity and they're getting the job done. And, you know, for him, I'm so thankful. I think there's been a lot of people in his life recently around Lock Haven, the community. That's what's special about our community, is that we embrace guys like Chance Marsteller who want to be different, who want to be special, and we help them develop into young athletes, young men, successful business. These guys are studs, you know, and that's what it's all about for our program. That's what means the most, not the winning, but the development of these student athletes.
Chance has got another one tonight. You got to get Ronnie prepared for the weigh-in and the finals tomorrow. You got anything else for me, Coach?
I'm just loving it, man. Best weekend of my life.
Congratulations.
Thank you.